Up next on My Disney Brain, cool birthday freebies and celebrating birthdays at Walt Disney World. Stay tuned for more.
Psst, avast there. It be too late to alter course, mateys. And there be plundering pirates lurking in every cove, waiting to board. Sit closer together and keep your ruddy hands inboard. That be the best way to repel boarders. And mark well me words, mateys. Dead men tell no tales.
Hello and welcome to My Disney Brain Podcast. A creative, imaginative, and family-oriented podcast with a brown-eyed perspective. Join us each week for theme park news and updates, family vacation planning tips and tricks, as well as fun family insights and memories from prior visits or hopes of visits to come. My Disney Brain Podcast is your podcast for the magic that keeps you motivated until your next Walt Disney World vacation. Thanks for joining us. This week, we are collaborating with Disney podcasters Susie and Matt over at Imagine Ears, E-A-R-S. Matt and Susie joined myself and the girls in the studio, and we talked about celebrating birthdays at Walt Disney World, birthday freebies and things that you can do at the parks for free during your birthday. So this is going to be a great show for you, particularly if you go to the parks during your birthdays. So thanks for joining us. And if you've not done so already, please make sure that you are subscribed to our podcast. And also go and check out Matt and Susie over at Imagine Ears, E-A-R-S. And also, guys, before we jump into the conversation, I wanted to highlight a new friend that we came in contact with on Instagram. His tag is David the Diz Dad, David the D-I-S Dad. The reason that we're highlighting his YouTube channel is because I thought it was such a cool thing that he's doing. So I'm going to read to you real quickly what he sent to us. He started following us, so he said, thank you. I also have started a YouTube page to help show kids, mainly with special needs, how the rides or attractions go and how they move about. There are not many videos, I guess he's saying, video channels out there that did this before he took his kids. So his son is nonverbal with autism. And for the first time, he writes, I think that it helped him understand the parks and a little bit more about what was going on at Walt Disney World. So he has some great videos, guys. David the Diz Dad. David the Diz Dad. So we just wanted to shout him out. We'll probably be doing that each week as we come across more and more cool Walt Disney World folks. So here we go. We're going to jump into the conversation. You're going to learn about some cool things that you can do at Walt Disney World on your birthday. Thanks for joining us.
Well, hey, guys. How are y'all doing?
Good. Hey. How are you?
We are doing awesome. We are so excited to partner up with you guys for this episode. I think this is going to be a lot of fun.
Yeah, we're super excited. We are really glad you were very receptive to doing this. So we're looking forward to doing this and maybe doing it more in the future.
Yeah, you know, that's what I think makes a lot of the Disney podcast community just so much fun. You know, just really enjoyable people to talk to, nice people, and you know, people who are just like-minded and
get it.
yeah we love Disney, and it's just a lot of fun to partner with other people in the community. So yeah, we're really excited to do this episode with you guys.
Cool, thank you.
So the topic tonight is going to be birthday freebies at Disney World. So I know that this was your idea that you pitched to us, so we're kind of going to let you guys start off and kind of get this show rolling for this evening.
Okay, cool beans. So we have three, and we'll start off with Nia, and she'll get us going. Oh, I'm sorry. Who wants to start?
See, not at all. You can always go first.
I can go first.
That is how it goes.
This is the dynamic of the show. So welcome to the family, Matt and Susie.
Love it.
I will go first. But no, this is really exciting. Celebrations really of any kind at Disney are always fun, but birthdays in particular are pretty awesome. We're actually going to be celebrating a birthday tomorrow.
Oh, happy birthday!
Someone
is turning an age tomorrow.
this episode is really fitting.
yeah.
Mail you a pin or something.
Right. And he usually has all of his pins and stuff, but this, like, my celebration hack or what have you for Disney is, if it is your birthday, like, in addition to getting your celebratory pin and being able to walk around the parks, and your cast members will salute you and they'll say happy birthday. Some of them will sing to you in the middle of the street or in public or wherever you are. And I know, like, specifically if you're in Hollywood Studios, they'll, like, point you to, like, a secret telephone that has Goofy on it, and Goofy will tell you happy birthday on it. So that's pretty cool. And just, like, sometimes if you're, like, at your dinner reservation and you have your pin on and they know that it's your birthday, they'll sing you happy birthday and, like, give you something of whatever. But I just like the VIP treatment that you get from your cast members that comes for just being born.
Yeah, I mean, yeah. I think that's definitely on both of our lists. Just, really... just getting the special treatment from the cast members, and it's a lot of fun, just like, even when it's not my birthday, but seeing this is the travel agent in me, just seeing other people having a great time on their trip, and having a good birthday in the park. So,
or people who may not want the cast members drawing attention to them, yes, and singing in a restaurant or something.
Yeah, also,
those are always fun to watch too.
Yeah. You want us to go again, or you guys have one, or you want to go back? And how do you want to do it?
Yeah, we can do a little round robin. So,
do we want to do ours by age, Matt? Because you're gonna have to go first.
Wow. Okay. All right. Fine. I'll go next. So I know this is kind of cheating. I'm a big coffee drinker. So I like Starbucks, and if you are a Starbucks Rewards member, you typically get a drink on your birthday. And I, if you're in the parks, now that Disney has partnered with Starbucks, and there's a Starbucks in each of the Disney parks, you can go get that free drink at any Starbucks location. So Magic Kingdom, they're on Main Street, Animal Kingdom, and Hollywood Studios there on Hollywood Boulevard, and the Epcot one has obviously moved because it was demolished, but the new one that they have actually built is actually really nice. So I think that having a Starbucks in the parks is a lot of fun, and it's even better on your birthday. It's a nice way to start your day, especially if you are rope dropping the park. Get that extra boost of energy.
Yeah. Are you surprised that Starbucks are as popular as they are, even inside the parks with so many other options?
I am. I think it's, this is going to sound bad, I hope none of my friends listen. I think it's a little annoying when in the morning, it's like, let's go, lines are shorter, no, I need a coffee, we just had a coffee at the hotel. Like, I'm not a coffee drinker, but I think there's that mentality of, like, Starbucks or like the ritual of it. So it does surprise me when there's Joffrey's, which I know people who prefer Joffrey's over Starbucks. So
yeah,
I don't know.
All the people taking selfies, I thought it was just me, with their Starbucks, like in front of the castle.
Yeah. All right. Well, our number two.
Okay. Well, this one kind of saddens me because I don't think we knew this when we were still eating meat. Otherwise, this would have been good for us to do because we kicked off our trip like this. We went to Disney Springs, first place we went, Earl of Sandwich. You could get a free sandwich on your birthday. Now, for like vegans and vegetarians like us, I apologize.
There you go. Finally, I'm in the majority on a show.
Here and here I am over here in the corner. I'll tell you what, if we're ever in the parks together on your birthday, I will gladly take the sandwich from you. So there you go.
Yes, we're all vegetarians here.
Yay! Yeah.
Yeah,
love it. Yeah. I know this is a little off topic, but what's your favorite? Disney's been doing a great job adding new vegan options to their menus. Do you have a favorite, like impossible, you know, fake meat replacement or just a vegan item at Disney World?
I don't think we've been back since like those options have been available. Like now, like we're so used to being like vegetarian when we go places, we just get stuff that's not meat related. So like we'll go and just get like vegetables or ice cream or just like, you know, other things. I don't think we've been back to partake in the impossible burgers.
Yes and no. Remember, we've been to Deluxe.
I think she was inside the parks.
Well, inside the parks, no, because I'll tell you, a few years ago, our favorite was Be Our Guest. And it's sort of still our favorite, but we've not gone in 3 years, two and a half, 3 years. Mm-hmm. And so we switched over about 2.5-3 years ago.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And so we're hoping, fingers crossed, when we get back. I did read what you're saying, Susie, in terms of a lot more options for plant-based folks in the parks. But we don't always fancy fake meat options.
Yeah, I understand that.
Have Disney's got some really good chefs, and I think they're very creative. We watched quite a few vlogs, and at Food and Wine, they were very creative. Even this year with the limited offerings, we thought that they came across with quite a few vegan and vegetarian options for folks that, you know, some was the Beyond Meat stuff, but others were just creative chefs being creative. So we're looking forward to it.
No, I understand that. My dad was a vegetarian, so growing up we just didn't eat a lot of meat. So whenever I was looking to, you know, plan our trips over the last few years and we're looking where to go, I'd always look at menu to see like what those options were. And so there weren't as many meat replacement, like so we frequented like Tangerine Cafe in Morocco with the hummus and the couscous and, you know, everything there. But I love hearing that. Maybe we'll have to do a whole episode about it. And Matt doesn't have anything to say.
Excuse me. I feel like I need to defend myself here.
This is the one time you can't be like, we're still eating.
I actually enjoy vegan and vegetarian options every once in a while. Thank you very much. One of my favorite things is the forbidden roll at California Grill. So, it's forbidden rice and shiitake mushrooms and mango. Mm. So it's actually really nice. So I do enjoy alternative options every once in a while. Thank you.
All right. Well, then next time we're down there, I think we're going to be at Animal Kingdom together coming up soon. We have to get the tofu option at Satouli.
Okay. Yeah, I'll be down with that.
We'll take you up on the offer, because that's actually a show topic that we have scribbled on our list of, you know, ideas to things to do. And we just haven't done it. And we certainly will be open to doing it, because I know there's a lot of folks that would be interested in knowing where would we go? What did we think? And what would we recommend? You know, everybody's trying to, you know, maximize their time, and I think a good recommendation on a plant-based option in each park could really benefit folks.
I agree. Yeah, and there's so many people with new dietary restrictions with gluten and you know just different things in general. Yeah, Disney's so flexible with all that. Wow, I'm really excited.
Yeah.
I mean, birthdays are fun too, but I'm like, yay, vegetarian, yay, vegan. Plant power.
That's cool.
Well, awesome. Susie, I think it's your turn.
Yeah, I think it's back to me. I love that we just talked about Earl of Sandwich, because what I wanted to bring up, we're going to stay at Disney Springs for a little bit. And all of these, you know, some things aren't always guaranteed, or you may need to be part of like a restaurant like Disney Springs, you know, something there specifically, if they have like a loyalty program. See what you have, you know, that you can get free for your birthday. But If you're part of the Sprinkles Perks program, you can get a free cupcake. So after your Earl of Sandwich, just go in and get a cupcake there. And there are vegan options at Sprinkles. So if you fall into both of those categories, you can go there if you're part of their Perks program and get a free cupcake, or just sign up, you know, maybe a few minutes before, because it's worth it.
Yeah. Yeah, it really is. That program, we have a Sprinkles, or had a Sprinkles here.
We have one.
Is it still one in Lenox?
Yeah.
I thought they closed.
They just go without you.
Well, you know what? I've been to Lenox lately. I don't think it's there anymore.
It could be closed.
Because Lenox is one of the bigger malls here in Atlanta, and Sprinkles was there. I just don't think, I could be wrong. I tell you, I'll look it up. But anyway, I used to be a part of that program, the Sprinkles program, mm-hmm. and I know at least the last 2 years when it was open, we went out there, and you do get the free cupcake. I've got it myself, and it is very good.
Yeah, so just be aware that, you know, if you're in the park, or if you're local and you're not going to a park and it's your birthday, there are different options with the different, you know, partners at Disney Springs that have plenty of things for you there too.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah. That was going to sort of be part of mine, Susie. So I'll have to.
I'm sorry.
No, it's fine. We always do two on this side of the table, because we all go together all the time, and we know we're going to take one of our ideas. So we always come, you know, with a little extra in hand. Mine, though, is similar to what you're saying in terms of a dessert option. But like Imani said initially, it works best when you have the pin. And I guess we shouldn't assume everybody knows what the pin is. If you're celebrating, just getting married, first time to the park, birthday, of course, it could be anything, because I've seen people celebrating divorces and other things. you can go to the best place, in our opinion, to go and get your pin is at Disney Springs at Member Services. Actually it's very close to Deluxe and Blaze.
Yes.
So you can go there. And the reason we say go to Disney Springs and get your pin is because you waste time when you go to a town hall and place like that, when you get into Magic Kingdom and into the park, you could be, you know, going onto your attraction. So we would advise, if you went to Disney Springs, you know, your travel day, you're getting down there, you're going to go get some dinner, head on over to Member Services. They'll take care of you. You say, hey, what are you celebrating? And a cast member will give you a pin, and they'll write in your name. It'll say what you're celebrating. Mm-hmm. And because we normally go during my birthday week, which is this week, and like you said, Susie, you'll be down there next week. Normally we would be there next week also. And I've always been in the park the last, I don't know, 10 years or so with that pin on. So I really resonate with what Imani was saying in terms of the attention that you get from cast members, whether you're standing in line waiting for an attraction, whether you're driving through going to parking, or whether you're just hanging out in the parks. People are very, very, the cast members are super awesome, and they always reach out. They ask you, you know, how you're doing, everyone treating you well. And I think it was about 3 years ago, I'm getting a little off topic, but I'm going to get to my dessert. About 3 years ago, there was a gentleman at Emporium, and he was assigning our pins. This is when you could get it, you know, on Main Street. Well, he asked what we were there for, and we told him, and he stopped everyone in the Emporium. I kid you not.
Yeah.
And they all sang happy birthday to me in the Emporium.
Love it. Oh my gosh.
It was really great.
It was great to see the look on his face, because he is one of those people who prefer that to not happen.
Same.
As much as he did appreciate it, we, being his children, could tell that he was intensely uncomfortable.
That's why I avoid Monsters, Inc.'s Laugh Floor at all costs, though.
Oh, you're definitely going to be that guy with the beard. Yeah. And yeah, you're going to get on the screen for
sure. I'm pegged.
Now, when is your actual birthday? Because we're normally down there this time of year, and it usually coincides with Mickey's birthday, usually the time that we're there in November.
Yeah, my birthday's tomorrow, so Friday the 13th is the lucky day. Yeah,
nice.
So
a few days before Mickey's. So just that in mind, usually there's also like little Mickey stuff for his birthday. Sometimes we've had like happy birthday Mickey pins and stuff like that too. So yeah, that's a really fun touch that they do for him, even though we don't get free ice cream or anything for Mickey, but you know, it is what it is.
Well, if you have that pin on and you're going to your dining or whatever your reservation is, you know, for lunch that day, chances are a cast member will see it. And, you know, from cupcake to ice cream or sundae, there's some sort of dessert in hand. But again, it works best if you have the pin on. Now, I'm sure you could bring it to a cast member's attention and show your ID or whatever the case may be. But if you have the pin on, it just kind of happens. You know what we love about going to Disney, we being all of the Disney nerds? We just love those spontaneous cast member magical moments. And it just happens. You know, you don't have to insert yourself. Cast members see it. They're awesome. They know what comes next. And they just make it happen. So if you have that pin on and you're dining anywhere, honestly, your dessert options will probably be a little different depending on where you are. But chances are, there's a free dessert in the making for you.
I've gotten a couple of free LeFou's brews with my birthday button.
I got not birthday, but just the power of the I'm celebrating pin when I graduated high school, which is coming up on 9 years, and I'm really scared because we're getting close to 10. But there's you know, the I'm celebrating, you know, whatever it is. So I was graduating and we were on a Disney cruise and just got the most amazing like cookie pie thing with ice cream. So yeah, whatever you're celebrating, be sure to let somebody know. And I love that tip about going to Disney Springs, because most people, especially now with the park reservation system, you want a full day, you know, to do whatever you want to do without fast passes. So don't waste part of that time by standing in line, you know, the day you get in, you know, before you go to the park, go and get that pin. I think that's a great idea.
Yep.
Yeah. Yeah.
Good deal.
Wow.
So back to you, Matt.
Oh, back to me. Okay, great. So, so I have one more, and I thought about putting this one in, but so you can't get it right now because the place no longer exists, but we have been told that it is coming back. So before its demolition in Epcot, Club Cool, you could actually go in on your birthday. And in addition to the free fountain drinks that you could get to taste, you could also go up and get a free icy on your birthday.
I never did that, and I'm really sad. I wish I'd known about that beforehand.
And perfect way. So my birthday is in September, and in Florida in September, it's still blazing hot outside on most days. So an icy was a nice way to kind of cool off for a little bit. But it is not there anymore, but they have said that it will be returning in some form or fashion later on. So Epcot's kind of a mess right now construction wise.
Really?
And projects on hold and like delayed. I'm not sure exactly how high up the food chain a free soda machine is. So
it's right below the Moana attraction. Yeah,
so we'll see if that
you know, that area is pretty popular. The number of vloggers over the years that I've seen go in and trick people into tasting that Beverly.
Oh, the Beverly,
hilarious.
Yeah, that was such an iconic thing. I hope it comes back in some way, but
we'll see what happens.
Epcot's just really tricky right now. In the next few years, it's probably the where they're going to be putting the most money.
It was supposed to be
the chopping block.
It was supposed to be the hub, the center of the 50th celebration. Why it wasn't the Magic Kingdom, I don't know, but they announced it was going to be Epcot. That was going to be kind of festival center.
Were they going to have the actual festival center, the three-tier thing completed by October? Was that the plan?
I think that may have been the plan, but obviously things have changed. So I don't even think we're getting that anymore.
A lot of things have changed.
So
Well, we're hoping with
somebody's busy behind those scrims and they're not just so, you know, hiding nails and you know, nail guns. But with Magic Kingdom coming up on its 50th next year, we're super excited about that. So hopefully, guys, if we don't see you and meet you in person before then, we can, you know, plan something, because we're making reservations now to be in the parks next year for the 50th. That's a done deal. We had to sacrifice this year. I told my family we'd do a do-over for my birthday, so I'm gonna have two of these birthdays, and one is gonna be in the parks. And so we've already reached out and secured some reservations for next year, so we're definitely going to be in the parks next year.
Now, are you going to try to be there on October 1st?
You know, here's the thing. My folks like to travel a lot, and for the last, you guys are travel agents, you're like, great. So the fourth quarter has been, the last few years in this house has been the busiest. So we normally, our normal modus operandi has landed us, my anniversary is in September, so my wife and I are usually somewhere. And then October, there's our Gatlinburg Pigeon Forge trip, which is fall, see the leaves fall in the mountains. Mm-hmm. And then we ease down into Florida in November. And normally we're at a family member somewhere in December. So we have traveled for the fourth quarter for the last few years, notwithstanding this year, of course. And last year, I think, Wimby, we missed a month. But to answer your question, we've never done Mickey's Not So Scary. And I really want to do that next year. And then I want to be back again in November. So in order to do that, I've got to meet the requirements of these folks for the first quarter through the third quarter with some other trips to some other places before then. So to answer your question, Matt, I'd love to be there on the first, but I know that Mickey's Not So Scary is probably a bigger target for me. And then, of course, being back for my birthday, which is basically like being there for Christmas, because Susie, when you go next week, you're going to get to see the trees and the decorations and all that good stuff.
Oh, you got to do the Halloween party. And I can only imagine that, you know, Lord willing, everything is good to do it. I have all ideas. They're going to pull out all the stops when it comes back, because they've been adding on so many new elements, and of course even like, you know, additional ticket things through that with dessert, you know, parties and things at the Halloween party. But I prefer the Halloween party over the Christmas party, so you definitely have to go.
I agree, I think the Halloween party, both parties are very enjoyable, but the Halloween party is my favorite as well. So
We've been in the parks on Christmas Day,
yes,
and we've had experience the we're very brave. If I told you how many people was with us, you would try to fact check us. This was a big family trip, extended family. There were a total of 18 of us trucking through the park.
Together as a unit, and our sergeant general.
Did you have a flag?
A flag. We're like, flag.
Yeah, Sergeant General here. We're up at 5. We're gonna be there at 7. We will be there for one drop. We will be at 9:30.
Well,
everything was planned.
Let me tell you, it was one of the best trips we've ever had, and I do it again. I wouldn't think about it, but I do it again in a heartbeat. So,
yeah. Well, hope everything works out so you guys are able to come back next year for all these awesome adventures. And, you know, let us know whenever you're in the area, because odds are we probably will be too, at least one of us. So we'd love to say hi.
Most of my trips are spur of the moment anyway. Like, Susie's going to be down there next week. I'm probably just going to drive down for the day on Friday and meet up with her and do some stuff in Animal Kingdom. So, Yeah. If you guys are ever in the area, we'd love to meet up. So,
yeah, that'll be great. Do we have any more to share?
I have I actually this time have an honorable mention because King of the Honorable Mentions here always has like four honorable mentions. No, I just have one. If you have, like, you know, we've all said it's easier with your birthday pin, and you know you're there and it's your birthday, a cast member might, usually I believe they say they do it more so in Hollywood studios, but they'll give you a birthday card from Mickey. And it'll say like "Happy Birthday from Mickey Mouse" or something like that, and that's like another free thing that they'll give you.
Yeah, we should have prefaced it by saying Imani spent some time in the college program and was a cast member there. For
she knows all the secrets.
Yeah, so she knows all the secrets and the tricks and these sorts of things. So
I don't know what are you talking about.
Yeah, Nia, did you want to talk to Ghirardelli? That one.
Ghirardelli, they will give you a free chocolate, but if you're going to do this, I highly recommend that you do this at the end of your day, because walking around in hot Florida with rich chocolate is sweet. You're going to want to share it. I understand people are like, no, it's my birthday, I can eat the whole thing. No, you can't.
Have you ever had the drinking chocolate from Ghirardelli? Oh, man. Yeah.
It should be illegal.
It's like, it's the way they drink it. It's like kitchen sink Ghirardelli chocolate. Like, they're both very much so like diabetic shock things that like gallons of water are needed to have.
Yeah.
Matt and I have a Beaches and Cream appointment coming up in January, and so we're gonna try to
do the same.
Now I'm just concerned because it's late in the day, and I'm like, I don't know if I can, like, how do I pace myself like throughout the day to get ready for this? I don't know.
Susie,
It hit me later because my roommates and I went, and it was like six of us, and we couldn't finish it. But of course, there's a table with 2 6-year-olds next to us, and they finished it in like 5 minutes.
Yeah.
And I was like, they're never going to sleep again. Like, congratulations.
Susie has not
done it. Went through the
whole
day, made sure we drank water. We got back, and I was like, I have a terrible headache. Like, am I dying? Like, I can feel all the sugar in my body doing this.
No. Oh, gosh. Maybe we won't finish it then.
Take pictures.
Yes.
Oh, yeah, yes, we will.
You can tell people about it.
There'll be probably video evidence of this attempt. So,
yeah.
This will be fun.
Yeah.
Good deal. Well, this has been really fun. Like, I'm so glad we were finally able to do this with you guys. Absolute pleasure to talk with you tonight. That was a really fun topic.
Likewise.
We have to do it again.
We're open, Matt and Susie, to doing this anytime. You guys have a open invite to share on my Disney Brain platform anytime you want. We're always looking for, you know, cool folks like yourself that just love Disney, and we could talk it all day, of course, and just provide good content to the listeners. Because before we started the podcast, we were on the other end. I would turn on and I would just want to hear something other than music and God knows the news. And I would just like to listen to someone talk about, you know, Walt Disney World. I can't go because I'm not there that close where I can go like an annual pass holder. But to listen to someone talk, and most importantly, one of the things that we do on My Disney Brain is sometimes we'll cut in with some sounds of the park, just so you can hear somebody on attraction or hear somebody on Main Street or hear a castle projection. And for someone that's not close to the parks, that's a pretty big deal. You know, that's a pretty big deal to feel like you're still connected, even though, you know, November's sometimes a long way away, you know, the next time you go. So thanks.
Yeah, it was great. So looking forward to our next episode together for sure. So
And we want to go over social media where people can find you guys. And then Matt knows all of our stuff. I just follow whatever I'm supposed to do.
So these are social media experts here. You want to tell them all our social media?
Yes, all of our social media on Instagram and Facebook is at My Disney Brain. You can find us at My Disney Brain, all spelled normally with no special punctuations or letters, on both Facebook and Instagram. And the website is mydisneybrain.com.
Fantastic.
Awesome.
And for you guys listening via the My Disney Brain podcast, you can find me and Susie over at the Imagineers Disney podcast. We're on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, YouTube. Just search for the Imagineers. And the way we actually spell that is the word imagine and then the word ears, E-A-R-S. So those two words squished together.
Mickey ears. Yes. Ulysses yes. Yeah. ears. And we're not smart enough to be actual Imagineers. So.
Right. I wish, but we're not.
I wish too. Yeah.
We have gotten those emails.
Cool.
How do you become an Imagineer? become an engineering major.
We need to check too. We'll help you.
We would love for you guys to come check us out. And of course, for all the people listening to our podcast, come check out My Disney Brain. They put out some awesome content. Love their Twitter feed. Their Instagram feed. You guys are killing it there. So,
Thanks.
Guys, thanks for joining us this week. Hope you enjoyed this podcast. Again, go and subscribe to My Disney Brain if you've not done so already. And please leave us a 5-star review. And again, thanks and a big shout out to Matt and Susie. Go and check them out at Imagine Ears, E-A-R-S. You can find them pretty much wherever you listen to podcasts. Imagine Ears. And their tag also on Instagram is Imagine Ears, E-A-R-S. We will be back next week with more great Disney content. I hope you guys have a great day and a great week. Oh,